And in fact, the whole thing about networking and automated ways of doing it, I'm very, I deleted my Clout account. I've not got involved in any of the other, peer index or cred or anything like that, because I don't want to have relationships managed by algorithms. And I still value the kind of networks, the fact that we know each other and the fact that we know lots of people in common through our blogging networks, and blogging's still seen as old school, but I think there is something about the type of ideas that we share and the way we learn about each other that's very powerful and very profound, and I'm happier handcrafting a network of smart people who I trust to filter the signal from the noise on the web. But that takes effort. That takes an appreciation of the problem, a willingness to solve the problem, and an ongoing degree of effort to do that. And actually, going back to your question about skills, those are the sort of skills. The willingness to take responsibility, to realize nobody's going to sort it for you, that if we all collectively get good at this, then as a society, the amount of quality information will has got so much potential to just, it's evolution and learning on steroids, isn't it? I spent 20 years in a big organization, in a big corporation, and I'm very aware of how challenging that is and how dysfunctional they can be and how non-trivial it is to assert a way of looking at the world within that context. But it is possible, and I stopped going to meetings that I thought were pointless, and said so. I made sure that most of my meetings were with energetic, interesting people who were helping me to get things done, rather than just because they had a job title or whatever that I was. I think, and even in very, very small, modest ways, I think it's possible. I think it's necessary to start carving out little bits of space for yourself in a corporation. Loic Lemire once described me as an intrapreneur, which I thought was a nice way of looking at it, that you've entrepreneurial instincts and attitudes, but you're existing within a large corporate setting. And I sort of then you find yourself thinking, well, yeah, but could everybody operate like that in a big corporation? Yes, I don't see why not, actually. So long as they did so. I mean, this is what's such a big change. They would have to, shrug off that victim mentality. This is why, again, the first chapter of the book's called We All Have to Grow Up. If we grow up and take responsibility, and in corporate life, there's a duplicity. It suits people to let the grown-ups be in charge, because then you can blame them when things go wrong, or you can bunk off school and not do what you might, but I think with the right inclinations and the right strength of character, then a management culture could begin to encourage that behaviour, could begin to weed out those who are not prepared to accept those changed expectations of them. I don't think it's inevitable that we end up as broken as we are in big organisations.